Hi there, smart drivers. Rick with Smart Drive Test. Quick tip for trucking smart, your leak test, which you not only have to do as part of your daily pre-trip inspection for new drivers, you also have to do it as part of your license test. And for a leak test, after you do all of the other in-cab checks on your air brake system, you're allowed to lose 3 pounds after the initial drop, after you apply the service brakes. So you have your wheels chocked and your brakes, your parking brakes released. You make a full service brake application after the initial drop. On a single unit, you're allowed to lose 3 pounds. On a tractor trailer, you're allowed to lose 4 pounds. And on a truck with two trailers or multiple trailers, you're allowed to lose 6 pounds. So you have to do a leak test. Now on this truck is a year old. It's not a very old truck. It only has about 8,000 kilometers on it. So we just did a brake adjustment and we put the service brakes on. The brakes are released. And one of the reasons that you release the parking brakes and chock the wheels and have over 90 pounds of pressure in the system is to detect air leaks. If you have air leaks on the system, you obviously know there's something wrong, so it has to be repaired. And if you lose more than those allowable limits, it has to go into a mechanic and be checked, because it's, you're going to be out of service and you're not going to be able to operate the vehicle. So you can see right now I have the parking brakes released and there's no air leaks. And so one of the things you're doing when you're doing around on your pre-trip and you have your wheels chocked with the parking brakes released with over 90 pounds, you're always listening for air leaks, because there's a lot of air in the system and that's what you're listening for. So right now I have the parking brakes released, there's no air leaks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply the service brakes and you'll hear that there's an air leak on this truck. So as soon as I put the service brakes on and applied the service brakes, I have a stick holding the brake pedal on. You can hear up here on the firewall, there is a leak in the air brake system. It's not a very big leak, but you can hear that. You could probably even hear that over the diesel engine. And I suspect because it's up here, now remember when you're in a car, you're sitting down here. When you're in a big truck, you're sitting up here. This is probably the brake pedal valve that's probably leaking a little bit there. And when I take it back, it's not a huge leak. It's a minor leak, but I'll take it back and I'll get them to check it. So leak test on a big truck, you need to do a leak test. Most of the time what a leak test is going to tell you is that you have a ripped diaphragm in one of the service brake chambers and a mechanic can switch those out pretty quickly, or one of the valves is leaking, as you can see here. So leak test, you have to do it as part of your pre-trip inspection every day. For new drivers taking a license, you have to do it as part and parcel of your in-cab pre-checks on the air brake system. Question for my smart drivers: have you ever found a ripped diaphragm on your vehicle by doing a leak test? Leave a comment down in the comment section there. All of that helps us out. I'm Rick with Smart Drive Test. Thanks very much for watching. If you like what you see here, share, subscribe, leave a comment down in the comment section. As well, hit that thumbs up button. Check out all the videos on the channel. Check out the videos over here. Check out the videos if you're working towards getting your license or starting a career as a truck or bus driver. Thanks again for watching. Good luck on your license. And remember, pick the best answer, not necessarily the right answer. Have a great day. Bye now.